Stand by, because I've got 5 cool tips and tricks for you to use in Zoom. Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. My name's Tony and this is Tony Dawson Tech. What I've got for you coming up are some tips and tricks that you can use in your Zoom meetings. But before we get into that, if this is your first time here, then welcome aboard. Think about hitting that subscribe button. And if you're a returning viewer, then thank you very much. I really do appreciate that support. So what have we got this week? Like I said, we have got 5 Zoom tips and tricks. Now, Zoom has come a long way, certainly in the last 12 months, and is now almost become a staple in our lives, along with other video conferencing applications. These tips and tricks will take your meeting to the next level and turn you into a Zoom ninja. Let's get started. The first one I've got for you is PowerPoint. Now, I'm not talking about using PowerPoint in the usual way of just sharing your screen and presenting it as you would do. I'm talking about using PowerPoint as a virtual background. This allows you to stay on screen and present it in a different way and makes it a little more interesting. Have a look at this.
Okay, so when you are in Zoom and you want to present your PowerPoint, you'd usually go to share screen and share the screen that your PowerPoint is on. And to do that, you do this and you choose your screen where the PowerPoint is on. Now, what you can do is if you go to advanced, as you can see now, you've got the option of PowerPoint as a virtual background. Once you click on this and go to share, you'll open up the window to choose where your PowerPoint presentation is. So this is one I made earlier, and as you open it up, you now get your PowerPoint on and it opens up, and look at that, you're on the screen. Now, the beauty of this is you can move your video around the screen wherever you want it. You can even resize it depending on the size of your presentation. If it's a busy slide, you can make it smaller. If it's not a busy slide, you can make it bigger. And from there, you can just control your slides. Even though it's just a virtual background, it's still operable as a PowerPoint presentation. And that's how you can do it. And if you don't want to do that, you can, using that button there for the options, you can take your video off PowerPoint like that. And that's it, really. It's a great feature. It just adds that little bit more to your PowerPoint to make it a little bit more interesting and keep eye contact with your attendees. Have a go. It's miles better than just presenting it in a boring old sharing screen.
Okay, tip number 2 is where you can have a little bit of fun with your camera on screen. These are video filters and effects that are built into Zoom themselves. Let's have a look what you can do with them.
And the next one we've got is video filters and effects. You probably wouldn't use it in a professional capacity, but certainly when meeting with friends and family during these times, then you could have a bit of fun. How do you do it? Well, if you just go down to the bottom where you've got your video options and where it says video settings, just above that you'll see choose video filter. If you click on that, this is the window that will open. You will then have the option to choose a video filter. Now, I've got a black background, so this is not easily shown, but you can change the color of your window. That's pretty much self-explanatory. It's not easy to show with a black background. However, you can have some fun here. You can have some lights across the top. If you ever wanted to be on the big screen, you could put yourself in a cinema mode, that sort of stuff. And if you want, let's say, a bit of a look. So them are the video filters. Something else that's new on the bottom, if you see that, we have studio effects. Now, there's little much there, but if you want bigger eyebrows, you can give yourself bigger eyebrows. If you've got no facial hair, you can give yourself some facial hair. And I suppose for the ladies, mostly, you can choose a lipstick. Doesn't suit me. Have a go. See what you think. Let me know.
Number three is a real simple one, especially if you use the whiteboard. Now, the whiteboard is there for use for mind mapping or brainstorming, that sort of stuff. But because it's a whiteboard and you have a white cursor, sometimes it's hard to follow the cursor. Well, in Zoom, you can spotlight that cursor with a simple click of the button. Here's how to do it.
So, spotlight cursor then. Let's have a look at this. This works really well on the whiteboard. Again, you go to share screen and choose whiteboard. I'll just quickly show you the whiteboard. This is one I did earlier, but it allows you to, exactly what it says, it's a whiteboard. You can add text, you can do some drawing. But like I said earlier, on a whiteboard with a white cursor, sometimes it's hard for your participants to see where the cursor is. Now, I use an aftermarket pointer highlighter, so I don't use this. However, if you haven't got that, if you go to Spotlight and then click on Spotlight, you will see this red dot appear where your cursor is. It's easier to follow for your participants, and when you finish, you can just turn it off. Simple but quite effective.
Number four is something that's quite simple but effective. During any meeting, especially if you're a presenter, sometimes you just want to ask questions. Now, previously, it's just been a thumbs up or you've had to get people to say stuff. What Zoom have now is something called non-verbal feedback, where participants can press things like yes, no, go faster, go slower. Have a look at this. It's a great addition.
Okay, before I show you the non-verbal feedback, you do need to turn this on in your settings. So in your Zoom account, go to settings. I think it's in meeting basic. Have a scroll down or you can search for it. But there you go. It says non-verbal feedback. This allows meeting participants to communicate without interrupting by clicking icons. Example, yes, no, go slower. Okay, so just turn that on. And then once they are turned on, in your meeting, down at the bottom where you see the reactions, once you click on that, you will see some new icons. And you will have yes, no, go slower, go faster, as well as the normal reactions. So a simple question asked by the presenter and you can get a reaction of yes or no, and they stay on the screen. I think it's 10 seconds. It's a small addition, but I think it can be really effective. Give it a go.
And last but not least, probably the most simple of them all, although it's my most used one now, is Zoom has a push to talk button. You know what it's like if you're on a meeting and you have to confirm or you just need to ask a quick question. Instead of using the mouse to go up to unmute and ask the question, then muting yourself, you can just press and hold the space bar to unmute yourself. Here's how to turn it on.
And my favorite one, again, which I use all the time now, it's so quick and so easy. It's the push to talk button for Zoom. Now, you do might need to check this is turned on, but again, for this, you need to go to your audio. So go down to the bottom and go to your audio settings. Within the audio settings, if you scroll all the way down, you'll see there is an option for press and hold space key to temporarily unmute yourself. And it's exactly what it says. So let's mute myself there. Now, if I'm in a presentation, someone's asking me a question, instead of having to move my cursor down to unmute, click it, and then click it again to unmute, all I simply need to do is press and hold the space bar. And as you'll see at the bottom, it says temporarily unmuted. I can answer the question and then I can let go and I'm back muted again. Really simple, but really effective. Love it. Give it a go. I'm sure you'll use it from now on in.
There you go. Hope you got some value for that. Let me know in the comments if you've got any more tips and tricks you want to share with the community. If you did find that useful, then please give me a like. It really does help the algorithm. It tells YouTube you like what you have watched today. If you haven't subscribed yet, that's up here. And here's a couple more videos I think you might like. Until Tuesday, guys, have a great weekend and I'll see you later. Bye-bye.